studied current electricity in class 10th. Okay, so more or less it takes similar concepts from class 10th. Okay, but the main difference is what? The kind of problems you are solving or you are dealing with. Okay, so the depth of understanding should be more. Okay, and then of course it will not be exactly like what you have done in class 10. There will be few more topics that you will be covering here, but then you know that series parallel connection and all that, you remembered Ohm's law, circuit. Okay, so all that will be in this chapter. This chapter is a very easy chapter. Okay, there are not many concepts. Fine, so what happens is that students take it lightly, so they will be like, okay, let me finish the difficult chapters first, then I can do these easy ones at the end also, and that end never comes. Fine, so follow the pace of the class. When I'm doing this, do this chapter, complete it. Once if you complete this chapter is guarantee you marks. Chapters like optics, modern physics, thermodynamics, thermal properties of matter, mechanical properties of solids, and this chapter, and magnetism also, in fact, they guarantee you marks. Fine, mechanics, electrostatics. Mechanics is huge, in fact, so you can't just ignore entire mechanics. But what I'm telling you, you will never be able to master these topics. Fine, so it may happen that in order to master these topics, you keep on spending more and more time. Okay, and you'll end up, you know, spending more than 70% of your study of physics in mechanics and electrostatics. Fine, that is not how you should do it. Okay, because these chapters you may not be able to solve a lot of questions in exam, and just to master these topics which are very difficult, you're leaving away the topics which are very simple. And of course these are not so simple that you will be able to complete it in one day or 2 days before the exam. You have to give good amount of time to this also. But again, the good part is in optics, thermal physics and modern physics and this chapter, there is not much of a difference between, you know, the kind of problem you will get in school, kind of problem you get in JEE Mains, in fact advanced also. There will not be too much of variation. But if you see the variation in mechanics, open any chapter in mechanics, school level, and then look at the JEE advanced question, there will be a huge gap. Fine, so it will take a lot of time for you to master up to that level. Fine, so we'll do this chapter in a very slow paced manner so that you will be able to understand all the concepts, because this chapter guarantees the full marks. Okay, so let's see how this chapter is divided or what all we will study in this particular chapter. Fine, write down. This chapter can be divided into three segments. The first segment talks about conduction. This is conduction. Here we will be taking care of micro factors affecting the flow of charge inside a conductor. Fine, and what kind of charge flows inside a conductor?
Electrons.
Fine, nucleus won't move here and there. It is free electrons in a conductor that moves. That is why it is called conductor. Fine, so this is conduction part. Here you will see that this particular section is very similar to kinetic theory of gases. In kinetic theory of gases, you had few assumptions and molecules were colliding, going here and there. Similarly, now we'll be making few assumptions for electron motion inside the conductor. Are you getting it? So electron will move inside a conductor, and when they move inside a conductor, they move freely. Just like gas molecules move in a room, similarly electrons can move in a similar fashion inside a conductor. Okay, the difference is electrons won't come out of conductor. They will require huge amount of energy or force to come out of metal. But the gaseous atoms, they don't need any such kind of threshold energy. Fine. So we'll study the motion of the free charges inside the metal first. Okay, we'll go into micro factors, as in how current depends on how many free electrons it has. Okay, and how current depends on with what velocity electron is moving. So all that we'll study here. Okay, next section is circuit analysis. So when we talk about current electricity, current flows when there is a circuit, there is a closed circuit, fine. So we'll be talking about how you can analyze a circuit. And when it comes to analysis of circuit, there can be multiple things. You will be asked to find out equivalent resistance. You will be asked to find out potential difference across a resistance or current through a resistance. There will be voltmeter, ammeter and all that will be there to measure the voltage and current. So all those kind of analysis will be here. So you'll be learning about few rules. Okay? So have you heard of Kirchhoff's rules?
Yeah.
Where?
It's a chapter. Radiation.
Okay. No, no, not that. Kirchhoff's loop rule. Kirchhoff junction rule. Have you heard of?
Yeah,
exactly. So we'll be learning about those rules and we'll be using it for analysis of circuits. Okay? So this, even though this may look like a small part, but the kind of numerical that will come here will be very large. Okay? In fact, the 70 to 80% of numericals will be from this particular section. Okay? Okay. Anyway, so this is circuit analysis. Alright? The last part of this chapter, okay, like always, is what? Any guesses? Application of whatever concepts you have learned. Okay? So you will be talking about here few instruments. Fine. Now electrical instruments are many. They are like, you know, you can't even, you know, count on your fingers. There are many, many. But in your syllabus, there are only few. Potentiometer, Wheatstone bridge and meter bridge. Fine. So you might have heard about them in physics lab. Yes or no?
Yeah.
Right. So we'll be talking about that in this particular chapter. Fine. And what happens is, once student studies this and this, they'll be like, okay, I'm done with the chapter, let's ignore. Fine. So that happens with almost every chapter. You just look at the last section of every chapter, you'll ignore it. Okay? And this everybody knows, it's not a secret. It's an open secret. Fine. So this, the person who is setting the paper, they also know it. And when they set a paper, they'll pick question from here. And 2018, two questions came in JEE Mains. Both were from this particular section. A small section, but they know that, okay, casual student would not have studied this. Fine. So we try to master this chapter from beginning till end. People think that this chapter is all about circuit analysis. No, there is a lot more to it. Okay. And in this entire chapter, we are primarily dealing with direct current. We'll be having batteries which supply direct current. Okay, the alternating current, when the current switches the polarity or the direction, sorry, that scenario we'll have it in a separate chapter altogether. So there is a huge chapter that is waiting for you, alternating current, that you'll study later on. Okay, okay. So first section of this chapter is conduction, or how the micro factor affects the current. Fine. Now tell me. Let us say, okay, this is metal piece, fine. Are electrons at rest inside this? They're moving at extremely high speed. It may be like 10^6 m/s, extremely high speed they are moving. Is there a current inside this? But charge is moving, isn't it? Electron is moving. And is electron moving just in a circle or they are moving? They are moving randomly also, right? It's not that they are just revolving around the nucleus. Fine. But then we are saying that current is zero. How come?
Net charge is zero.
Current is zero.
Net movement
is zero. So electron, one electron suppose starts moving, so it may move random. There is no force on it. Understand this. There is no net force on this electron. Okay? So this electron just keeps on moving in a random fashion. Fine? And if this keeps on moving in a random fashion and you try to find out its velocity and try to average its velocity for a very short span in time, you'll get average velocity as zero. Okay? That is only for one electron. But if you take all the electrons together, multiple electrons also if you take and take a snapshot at a particular time interval, you'll see that one electron goes like this, other electron will be going like this, one goes like that, other goes like this. Fine? So there are so many number, there is equal probability of one going like this, then one going in opposite direction. It's a random event. Fine? So the net movement of electron is zero. That is the reason why there is no net current. Fine? So just keep a metallic piece on your hand, the current will be zero, even if charges are moving. Now, in order to have current, do I need net charge? Yes or no?
Yes.
So when current is flowing in a copper wire, the copper wire has net charge?
Potential.
You need to have net charge or not? Can a neutral wire have current? Yes or no?
It can have.
Okay? Fine. There need not be net charge. It can be neutral. But protons are at rest and electrons are moving. So there is net movement of charge in a particular direction. Fine. If along with electron, proton also starts to move with the same velocity, then net current will be zero.
So electrons
What?
Electrons are so small, you need to take a single wire, they can keep moving in any direction.
Yeah, correct. So we'll be talking about that. So if you apply a potential difference, what happens? Electron will feel a force nudge towards that direction. During its motion upward, it may collide with another electron. Then it will be random after collision. But immediately after collision, it will feel a nudge in forward direction. So even if it is random, after connecting the battery also, if it is random, okay? But if you take an average, okay? Apart from random, there is another velocity which is caused by the battery which you have connected. Are you getting it? What I am trying to say is that electron can be moving like this. Fine. So you will see that there is net movement forward. Are you getting it? If you take the average of the velocity, you will get average velocity in this direction. Why? Because the battery is trying to push it in this direction. Fine. Okay. Now, it is the movement of charge that is current. Is this thing clear? And the matter on which the charge is moving, it need not have a net charge. Is that also clear? Okay. Now, I'll ask you to understand the flow of charge as if water is flowing in a pipe. Then things will be very simple. Okay. Just like water is flowing in a pipe, you have charge which is flowing in a conductor. Think like that. Okay? And there is a rate of flow of water. So that is water flow rate. Fine? So mass that is flown per second is mass flow rate of water. Fine? When it comes to current, okay? We don't count how much mass of electron are flowing per second. We count how much charge has flown per second. Fine. So amount of charge that is crossing a section per second is current. Write down definition of current. The amount of charge that is crossing a section every second is the magnitude of current. Fine. Any doubt on this? Fine. If electron is moving randomly, it goes like this, then this, then this, what will happen is that once it crosses the cross section, next time it comes out. So how much charge crossed the cross section? Net it is zero. Okay? In a time interval. But if you take so many electrons in a particular snapshot also, 5 electron goes this side, 5 electron will come that side. So what I am trying to say, if you take average of motion of one electron over a time, that is also zero. Or you take all the electrons together at a particular moment also, then also average motion is zero. Okay? Are you getting it? So did you understand the definition of current properly? Now tell me one thing. If there is an electron that is revolving around in a circle, electron charge is E, right? Suppose it revolves around a circle of radius R with velocity V. Okay? Find out the current due to this. Done? Done? Why is it so time? Tell me what is, how the current is flowing, in which direction? It is also in circle. In a circle only. Yeah. So how should be your cross section? You can take this as your cross section and see that in 1 second how much charge passes through this. Are you getting it? So electron suppose has just crossed this. So how much charge has crossed this cross section? E charge has crossed. Right? Next time, how much time will it take for this electron to again cross this section? V by 2 pi r. So can I say that in this time, this much charge is flowing? Are you getting it? In this much time, this charge is flowing. So in 1 second, how much charge is flowing? E divided by V by 2 pi r. Fine. So, just 2 pi r by v, sorry, 2 pi r by v. So this is 2 pi r by v. So it will be E v divided by 2 pi r. So this is the value of current due to the motion of electron. Any doubt on this? So one more thing you need to understand here is that, you know, whenever electricity bill come to your house, what are you paying for? Are you paying for the charge that is coming to your house? Suppose 1 coulomb charge comes inside your house. What you do with it? You use it to run refrigerator and AC and all that. Then what happens to that charge? It goes away. Okay? So amount of charge that is coming inside your house is equal to amount of charge that is going out from your house per second. Then why are you paying it? Why are you paying your bill?
Fuel, like to produce the electricity, right?
The movement of charge itself is required to, you know, to make sure your electrical instruments function. Fine? It's just like you are rotating a turbine with water jet.
Why
does
it save?
You, what?
Does it save electricity and all?
Anyway,
save charge.
No, see, when they say save electricity, they mean save electrical power. They don't say save charge. Charge is anyway conserved, it is zero, net charge is zero. Okay? In order to generate that flow rate, it requires a lot of effort. Fine. You need to put a turbine below the dam, and then dam water comes, hits the turbine, it rotates, then your coil rotates, and then You learned, right? AC generator and DC generator.
Yeah.
Fine. What happens, the coil becomes so heavy, so many turns, and this coil is like 3 or 4 stories big. So they don't rotate coil then anymore. They rotate the magnet.